हेलो, दिस इज़ मास्टर हिप्नोटिस्ट लक्ष्मण गुण एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अ ट्रू स्टोरी दैट टुक प्लेस ऑलमोस्ट 15 ईयर्स अगो। वन डे आई वॉज सिटिंग इन माई क्लिनिक। अ मंक केम इन माई क्लिनिक एंड टोल्ड दैट ही वॉज देयर फॉर कुंभ मेला। कुंभ मेला इज मेजर फेस्टिव इवेंट इन हिंदुइज्म। अ ह्यूज नंबर ऑफ हिंदूज फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर इंडिया गैदर फॉर दिस इवेंट। इट वॉज स्टार्टेड बाय आदि शंकरा इन 8th सेंचुरी फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ फिलोसॉफिकल डिस्कशन एंड इट इज गोइंग ऑन सिंस देन। दिस टाइम इट वॉज हेल्ड समवेयर इन महाराष्ट्र। वेल, दिस इवेंट इज नॉट रियली आवर फोकस, सो लेट्स गेट बैक टू द मॉन्क आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट हु हैड कम इन माई क्लिनिक। He told me briefly about himself and solicited some money. Since I wanted to get rid of him, quickly I put my hand in my pocket, got 2 rupee coin and kept on the table and asked him to take it. When he saw that it is only 2 rupee coin, he refused and scrawled it back towards me. As soon as he refused, I took my coin back and kept it in my pocket. After that, he started saying that you are so great doctor, blah blah blah, and demanded more money again. I ignored his talk and told him that he should have accepted it as it was donation. But it's okay, as you wish. Now I have some work to do. I am running out of time, so I requested him to leave. When I asked him to leave, he should have left, but instead he stood there only and mumbled, "I am not a beggar to take 2 rupee coin." When I heard it, I explained him that donations are offered, not demanded. And it is called begging when something is demanded. Even though I didn't label you a beggar at all, did I? Then he said, no, you didn't, but I cut his point and said, see, you can refuse it before me that you are not a beggar. Even you can shout before whole world that you are not a beggar. But can you refuse it before your own soul? Can you? Do you have that capability? Do you know why I am asking all these things? Because neither I called you a beggar nor anyone else. Even then you refuse that you are not a beggar. Why? Because it is your own innermost soul who is trying to tell you the truth about yourself. And you are trying to refuse it before me, isn't it? It doesn't matter for me whether you accept it before me or not. But it matters for you whether you accept it before your own soul or not. And your soul knows everything about you, who you are, and what you are. You can pretend before me, you can pretend before this whole world, but you can't pretend before your own soul. If you accepted your soul's voice, such negative statements would never come out from your mouth. There would always be a smile on your face. Your heart and mind always will be cool and calm. To be a real monk, first of all, you need to listen to your own soul's voice. And finally, I said that I have given you something priceless. If you are having divine eyes, you take it with you, otherwise You came empty handed and you would left empty handed. Saying this, I stopped and started observing him. He was almost frozen and was looking with still eyes. After a while, he got conscious, gritted, and left calmly. God knows whether he took it or left empty-handed. Thanks for watching my video. We'll see you in the next video.